back. Welcome back. It is Cocktails and Conversations, CCC, with your girl, Cornae. You know we here for another episode. So like I say every week, you know I got a special guest for y'all. And this guest is... She's up there. That's all I can say. She's doing her thing. She's been doing her thing. You know, most of these people out here are looking up to her because she's been out here doing her thing for so long. So we have Cutie in the building. Yes, Cutie. That's all she has. No last name. No first. Just like Prince.
What's so bad about that?
It's Cutie. That's all you need to know. Cutie House Boutique. You know how I go. You've been over there. You've been a Cutie before. Also, you know, we got a drink for y'all. So I got that Cutini for my guest because she's a Cutie. So we're going to do a little spin on a martini with a Cutini. Also, you know, I got my isms of the day. Lord knows what I'm going to say today. I don't know. We're going to see. But one thing's for certain, two things for sure. You will be understanding what I'm saying and you will be able to use it on another level, okay? So y'all tune in. Go do what you gotta do, you know. Go dry your feet off. Get your drawers out your booty. You know, get your food, whatever you need to do, and come back to Cocktails and Conversations right after this commercial.
Hair Artifice Salon is professional, affordable, and waiting for you. Give us a call or schedule online for the five-star look for less.
Juan, what's up? This is your people, Manny Fresh, and you're watching Mad Game Entertainment. You heard me? Don't change that.
Cocktails and Conversations. Y'all know what hour it is. It is Cornae-ism time. And what does that mean when I say Cornae-ism? It could be a word. It could be a phrase. It could be abbreviations. But you, one thing's for certain, two things for sure, you're going to understand what I'm saying. Okay, I'm going to let you know what it means to me. Okay, it can mean something else to y'all. But what it means to me that you can use at home. So today's ism is SOTM. SOTM. What does that mean? Think about it. Just you know, la 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 la. Just think about it. What do you think it means? It means stay out the mix. If it ain't your mix, stay out of it. Mind your business. Don't be a Karen.
I'm sorry, I can't share with you guys. I'm being threatened by a man in the Ramble. Please send the cops immediately.
Don't be a Karen worrying about the next person's thing.
I'm gonna tell them there's an African-American man threatening my life.
If they over here selling water on the street, let them sell water on the street. Stay out they mix. If they over here hoo-hawing, let them hoo-ho. If they hoo-ha, stay out the mix. SOTM, S-O-T-M, stay out the mix. And that is Cornae-ism of this week. So. Tune in next week for another ism, and we'll be right back after these commercials.
Trying to see the reaper. I can tell by the look in y'all face. Money up and I'm good always. This bag ain't coming no break. I'm the one they out here talking about. From the north to the south, everything in between.
I be thinking like I'm stopping on you. I be thinking like I'm stopping on you.
I've been getting money since like yesterday. Do your thing, I do mine, I don't never hate. Decided long ago, me and bro would separate. With the hate and the fate, had to segregate.
Hello
And welcome back to KC's Corner. Today, fellas, guys, gentlemen, lean in close, because we need to talk, okay? We really need to talk. You know how I've been talking to the ladies about taking care of everything and all the nether regions being okay and everything? So I'm gonna need y'all to do the same thing. Don't write to me, don't question me when I say, yes, you need a facial. Yes, you do. If you have ingrown hairs, if you have oiliness, if you have nothing going on at all, so you think, if your girl tells you you need a facial, just gonna do it. Okay, we started from the bottom, now we're here. We're gonna be right here, right here. You see these? Two. You should have two eyebrows. Not a caterpillar strip. We want to see your eyes. It'd be lovely, okay? So moving right along, underarms. We don't need to be able to braid them. Trim that stuff. Manscaping is so important. If you hadn't figured it out, that's what we're talking about today. Manscaping, you have to manscape, okay? Like, I shouldn't be able to braid up your underarms. Your chest hair shouldn't be sticking all out in here. Like, nobody trying to see that. This ain't the 80s. This ain't Miami Vice. Like, stop. No. Trim that. Wax it. Do something. If you grow a sweater on your back, no, you're gonna scare the kids in the pool. You got to wax that stuff. And let's move on down. Don't ask us to do what you're not willing to do, okay? All right. So let's trim it up, manscape it, make sure it looks nice and appetizing, and it'll be a whole lot easier for you to get what you want. And then some people say it makes you look a little big, so you can be like, girl, you see it. So you gotta manscape. I don't care who you are. I don't care how you feel about it. Yes, it's your body. Yes, you can do what you want with it, but yes, we want to do what we want with it, so I need you to do what I need you to do with it. And ladies, that goes for you too. So if you're thinking about walking around here with your Jumanji jungle, don't, take care of it. We trying to keep everybody together, and not offend them and smell you before you get to the room. pH is important, okay? pH is important. I told you I was gonna be on one today. I don't know if I told you, but I'm telling you now. So if you have a problem with it, you know my DMs. Phoenix Air LA _ on IG. Holla at me. I'm gonna get y'all together, okay? So until next time, manscape. Ladies, keep it together. Till next time, keep it together, keep it tight, keep it right. Take care of yourself, take care of each other. See you next week.
With the rise of racism and peace being taken from the world, it leaves a person to wonder, what's going on in the world? Sadly, these things are not going away. Read The Dog Whistleblower to find the link between racism and the coming Armageddon.
What's up? This is your girl Megan Good, and I want to give a shout out to Mad Game ENT.
Welcome back. You know what time it is. It is cocktail hour with Rainbow Bright. Me, yes, I'm a little colorful today, but hey, what's wrong with that? Anyway, let's get into this cutini, okay? First of all, get that shaker. You see it's condensing already? Condensation. Because I have ice in it already, you know. I come prepared. Clock, keep it locked, keep it clocked. Okay. The meat of the show today will be Tito's, because that's what my guests wanted. Also, we have some Dirty Tony Martini mix. You know, how you gonna make something dirty without Tony, okay? Dirty Tony makes it do. We got a little Mario olives, you know, that's just for garnish. And then we have some vermouth, okay? This ain't Vermouth, Vermont. Like, y'all be killing me with the names. If you don't know, ask for a drink. Know what you're talking about. Don't be going up to the bar saying all kind of crazy stuff, because we laugh at y'all later on. But anywho, That is our combination for today, so let's get started. First things first is the meats. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, you know. It don't matter how many ounces, it depends on your party. If you got 4, 5, 6 people, then you need to make probably half the bottle. But if you only got 2 people, then you can go with like 2 ounces, 4 ounces, or 2 per person. Depends on, you know, how much they like to drink. My guest, she says she don't want that sweet. Okay, serve that to the rest of the people. I ain't gonna say the name. Next, we have Dirty Tony's martini mix. You don't need a lot. Dirty martinis consist of olive juice. So if you don't like olives, then don't make a dirty martini. Make it something else. But anywho, so you need a little bit of that. This is about 2 to 3 ounces because you don't need much. This stuff is pretty potent. Next, you have the vermouth. Okay, not Vermont, not Vermouth, vermouth, muthy. Okay, make it moothy. Okay, this is to put the dryness in your martini. Some martinis are sweet. I never tasted a bubbly martini, even though I might have to make one, you know, who knows? But we're gonna keep it dry because like my guest said, she doesn't like sweet stuff. You know, that might mess up your little stomach or whatever. So we're gonna just go ahead and pour about 2 ounces of vermouth, 1 ounce per person because it's 2 people. Next. The fun part. Now, there's plenty of ways to shake. Just shake, shake, shake. You know how you fellas do it. You know, shake, shake, shake. Or, you know, you do it the professional way. You got to have your elbows out. You got to have your hand on the top. And you up, down, up, down, up, down. And you can do that about 15 times or so. But we don't have to do all that this time, okay? Because it's just a cutie teeny, okay? So, after that, got your garnish, of course, you know I made it cute for my girl Cutie, okay? And you just pour. And this is what you call a cutini. I'm gonna make sure I give my guest, you know, her share. I'm not gonna be greedy. Cutini, anyone? Who's ready to drink? I am. Right after these commercials on Cocktails and Conversations with your girl, Cornae.
Hey, yo, this D1, the one-man army. Better act like you know, Mr. I hope they hear me. Shout out to Mad Game Entertainment. Yeah.
Welcome back. Like I say, y'all, every week, you know, I got that heat. My guests, they be hot and on fire throughout the city. Like, ain't no question when you see it. So we got House of Cutie, okay? Boutique in the building. What's going on, Cutie?
What's up, Nate? What's up? Glad to be here.
Okay, we are happy to have you on Cocktails today. So we're going to dive into this tea. How long you been doing, you know, fashion or selling, you know, clothes or whatever? And for people that don't know, you know, let them know what you do.
What's up, you guys? It's your girl, Cutie, from House of Cutie Boutique. Yes, and we've been open going on 9 years, Nate.
Okay, like I told you.
A decade.
Doing this, okay?
Yes.
Most people don't even last that long.
Yes, before it was even thought about, you know, I mean, when you do what you want to do, your vision and what you got set for you, you're going to work it out through the storm.
Okay, so tell me how you even get started with this? What just made you say, you know, I'm going to start selling clothes. That's what I'm going to do.
Okay. Kind of had a little plan. I was working, and then I was off for like 6 months. So in them 6 months, I had to do something. I ain't want to go back.
Right.
And I got into real estate, you know, took the test, failed it a couple of times. First time I failed it, I got the boutique literally the next day. So I actually had 2 things wrote down. I wrote it down, manifested it. And I like nice things, but I don't like to go to the mall. So I always liked the boutiques, and it didn't have a lot of them. So I was going to New Orleans, finding them. Mm-hmm. And they wasn't our color. It wasn't none of that.
Okay. Not at the time when you started.
Black people having no boutiques, it didn't have none of that. Yeah, so I was just like, damn. I'm into, you know, my family into clothes. They've been making clothes, but people wasn't into that then. They wanted name brand stuff. So I'm like, damn, I could sell some name on
it. Okay.
And that's how it happened. And I went with my mood. I did, you know, I ain't even have no money, Nate. you know, not no money like that, no but loan.
Let
no
them know, baby. She started from the bottom, now she
yeah,
here.
Yeah, you know, like I ain't have no $1,000. You know what I'm saying? Of course, I was all right. I had my, you know, life was great working, yeah. Just regular girl. You know, I didn't have a $10,000. I ain't have a plan, like a big money plan. I
but
just
you,
went on and took
went
what I had.
You out on a limb.
I took what I had and I made it work and it worked. You know, we've been through a lot, but we still here and we is popping. So y'all make sure y'all check us out, House of Cutie Boutique.
Let them know where you're located
at. We're on Airline Highway, 4315 Airline Highway, Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Follow us on Instagram at House of Cutie Boutique. Make sure y'all click the link and order y'all some popping clothes.
Okay, because I'm about to go out of town and I need you to come over there and style me, baby. I'm gonna have to, you know, put this on the show as well, you know, me going over there and letting you style me. So you can see the people, because I don't know if you know, like, they got a lot of women out there that don't know what clothes go on their body.
Right.
Some women think, oh, the tighter it is, the better it's gonna be. No, when if you just loosen up your pants a little bit, it'll look like you ain't got that fupa that you
Thank
might be
you.
Hiding
Girl,
up in that
you
thing,
know.
But you got it too tight, so whatever it's yanking out, you know.
Girl, you right, though, for real, though. That's my main thing, telling people to, like, a lot of people don't like people try their clothes on, but I had to let them try it on because the clothes I was selling, they was new to it. You know, people was new to it. It's just popping. It's boutique clothing. They looking at it and think they gonna look this way, feel this way, or think they have a certain type of body. But you really didn't. You try it on, and I don't know. It don't matter how thin it is or however. Just the boutique clothes form you into a nice body.
Right.
It does. So I be like, try it on. They be like, oh my God, I don't have a stomach. You know.
So like, I understand down here. You know, like you said, you started this off 9 years ago.
Literally.
A lot of people wasn't doing this, but now, you know.
Everybody.
Everybody ain't mama doing it. Even though.
That's a good thing.
That is a good thing.
Right.
But everybody ain't got the same stuff.
And they,
you got that polyester, but I'm looking for that cotton.
Yeah, girl, you got to have that good
that
stuff.
That good stuff, that good stretch, is what y'all call
it. Yes, because for real, you know, us black girls, we got the big butt, so we got to have that stretch, baby. It's all about the fit.
So, with fashion, like, we're in summer right now, so what's on trend? Like, what you think that, you know, everybody in their household should have at least one thing of, you know, what's on trend right now?
Ooh, everybody should have them, definitely all into one, you know, just popping. They love all into ones. They don't never go away. They make your camouflage your stomach, make your stomach flat. So don't be scared of the all into ones. They definitely work out. And of course, you know, everybody showing some skin because, you know, this year, everybody got body. So I ain't gonna lie, it ain't even hard to sell stuff no more. Everybody got their body right.
So, wink,
yeah, everybody want a lot of mesh. Everybody want a lot of see-through right now.
I know. That's another thing, though, with... I'll be looking on boutique, you know. I can get girly if I want to, you know, but I don't want everything showing every time. Like, I can't get this two-piece set without it being mesh and see-through, you know, that's what's hot now, so I'm going to have to mesh it up.
Just got to mesh it up, It's always kind of cover-ups you can add to it.
Okay, and what you thinking about this cutini that I made for you
I
today?
Love this cutini. I ain't going to lie, because I'm a girl. I sip mine straight, but I must say it's good. As you can see, I'm bubbly over And it ain't sweet. I like this. I got to remember to order this, because... Everybody think I just want my drink straight to get drunk. I'm not a drinker.
No,
so
you
I want to
sip it and make it taste good.
And I just want to drink it without wasting it. When they mix it and we go to doing all that, I'm going to waste it. I'm not a drinker.
It's too sweet.
So as long as I know it's a drink, I can hit it. Girl, look, it's gone.
Okay.
Yes,
like well, I'm glad you're enjoying it. We're going to talk more with Miss Cutie on when we come back from this commercial break.
Boy Benzino, aka Zeno Grigio, and right now you're checking out Mad Game TV.
Welcome back. We're with my guest, Cutie, with the Cutini, and we just here talking about fashion. So, like I said, I asked you earlier, like, what's on trend or what colors that you think is really popping, and So what do you think? Well, what color? I asked you about the trend already.
Yeah, besides
you told me
the
about mesh.
Yeah, besides the mesh and everybody, you know, little skin showing, denim has been popping. Everybody been rocking denim, girl. You know, it's
denim on denim.
Denim and
white
boots.
White and denim.
Right. Nice diamond and denim.
Okay, dukes and boots. You know, we done had a few little pop-up parties down here. So denim is on trend now. Do you mess with, like, light denim, dark denim, or is it
I have to get, I ain't gonna lie, I get all the denims. I do. I get light denim, medium denim, and then I also get the black. At first, we didn't have so much black. Now, they're having the black, which is good, because everybody need a pair of black jeans.
Yeah, you know, black jeans, besides Levi's. $50.
Right, oh, mine's $55.
Okay. You got a little extra room in the back, so you're a little
fit, right.
$55.
They do a little fitting right, baby. Push it up. Yeah.
Good. So, I want to talk about, like, around here in Louisiana or Baton Rouge, I mean, they might do it in other states, but we're talking about our state here. They've been doing a lot of pop-up shops. So tell me about that. Like, how does that go? Do y'all
I
get
like
together? Do you reach out and say that you want to be a vendor? And vendor means that you want to sell your clothes?
Yeah. Pop-up shops, they've been awesome. And they happen a lot since the pandemic and all the other stuff. And it's been good, especially for black people, you know.
Especially for people who don't have a storefront.
Yeah. That too.
Okay.
Yeah, definitely good for people that
don't
have
a storefront.
Right, a storefront, but it's also good for just supporting black people, period, because they've been sticking together and they've been having these pop-ups, and it's not a trend. That's what's been trendy, girl, the pop-ups.
The pop-up shop.
And you pretty much, if you're the person setting it up, you pretty much reach out to the people, let them know, look, I'm having a pop-up, come attend, and, you know, y'all hook up. And I like the fact that other business owners get to meet other business owners. And it don't matter if you're selling the same thing, you know?
Well, also on pop-up shops, it's not only people with clothes. You know, they got the people out there with the sea malls.
Yes.
They got cooking vendors out there. They got women out there with drinks, you know, with the pouches and different things where you can set up catering if you want, you know. So that's a good thing because
it's awesome.
Everybody is networking.
Everybody, thank you. And that's what I like about it. Everybody is networking and stuff like that. So
do you have any upcoming pop-up shops?
I actually do. We have a wig and hair expo.
Okay.
And it's going to be pretty big, like the fashion show you was talking about. Mm-hmm.
Oh, we're going to get into that, too. I got to ask you about
that. Yeah, so it's kind of like a, you know, something like that with a great environment. That's what I liked. It was a great environment. Once again, people was able to network, like, the fashion, well, you asked me about that, but you know, people can come together even though they sell the same things. You know, they can come together.
It
they
don't
can
matter.
Find me.
It doesn't
they can
matter.
Find me. And that's a big thing because people need support. If you don't have nothing in this world, support is everything and it's for free. So support each other. Y'all keep doing y'all thing. Pop
nothing
up
to
are
like,
awesome, you know.
It's nothing to tag.
You know.
And it's nothing to share.
It's
all that's free.
Yes. Get out there. Support your brand.
Like they say, girl, why you ain't famous yet? Because you ain't sharing my
Because you ain't sharing my That's why I blame yourself.
Okay. So, you mentioned fashion show. Now, you just had a past fashion show. Let's talk about that. Like, who threw it? What was the name of it?
It was awesome. And it was a big thing for BR. It was BR Fashion Week.
Oh.
Shout out to my girl, Allie and Butter. Of course, House of Cutie was a sponsor. They gave this event. It turned out nice. And them girls rock. Shout out to y'all. They did it for the whole week. Like, they had something
that's
Friday,
what I was about
Saturday,
to ask you.
And Sunday.
Okay.
So they ended it with a bang because the fashion show, it was one of a kind. It was a night to remember.
And where was it?
It was at the Hilton, downtown Hilton. So it was at a great place. I'm talking about the dudes had their suits on. The girls had their nice dresses on. And of course, House of Cutie cut up. Shout out to House of Cutie.
Okay, because I seen the pictures, baby. I wasn't able to be there, but I seen the pictures. Very professional.
Very.
You know, it was on point.
Everything was professional. It was on point. The environment was the great setting. It's like, it was like a, you know, turn up the time. When I heard it started at 8 o'clock, I was really down with it. Like,
right,
come on,
like,
fashion
dang,
show at 8 that
late.
Night. That's
right.
Late on a Sunday.
Yeah, at least start about 5 or 6.
We finna turn up, and it was just that, a turn up. You know, great people. It was great for promotion. It was great for your brand. It was just awesome. Shout out to the models. You know, a lot of people, you know, was able to do their thing.
Together,
yeah, to come together
thing.
And do their thing. So y'all be looking forward. Follow me, because we got a hair and wig expo coming up. Same setting. It's going to be in Hammond, Louisiana. It's going to be popping. And vendors, y'all are welcome to sign up. Put your brand out there. Let the people know who you are.
Okay.
Yes.
Let's get into it. I'm not going to miss this one. I missed the last one.
Yeah, for real, Nate. This is in Hammond. Come out.
I'm coming.
You can come.
Also, I got to come to your shop because, like I said, I'm going out of town. I need you to style me. I need about 4 or 5 outfits.
Oh, girl,
and I'm
not
joking.
Oh, I would love to style
I am coming
you.
Over there, and when I post them, I ain't posting them, okay?
Yes, yes.
I've been working out. I'm trying to get my cutie ready.
Yes,
okay,
ready
I'm trying to get my
it.
Cutie ready for the cutie, okay?
Yes. Yes.
Well, Miss Cutie, House of Cutie, I just want to say thank you for coming on the show.
Thank y'all for having me.
Thank you for, you know, just giving
Let
your time.
Let me get my little sip on, girl, with this one.
You got it. Ooh. Sip it. But we'll be right back after this commercial with more cocktails and conversations.
Yes.
Welcome back, guys. It's the end of the show already. I know. It saddens me every time we get to this point. But, you know, it was a good show. I had my girl Cutie from House of Cutie Boutique. You know, she gonna hook me up later. I'm gonna go over there. I'm gonna have some, like, pre-clips for y'all to see that, you know, I'm really going over there to get my, you know, cutie on or whatever, okay? I had my Cornae-isms of the day, the sodom, stay out the mix. Mind your business and drink yours, like Johnny Hustle says. Mind yours and drink water, okay? And then also, you know, I had my cocktail, which is my cutini for my guests. It's oh so good. I might be a little tipsy, but I ain't gonna let y'all know that. But yeah, we had a great show. I can't wait till we come back next week. You know, I'm gonna have another guest for y'all. I'm gonna have another drink for y'all. And I'm gonna have another ism for y'all. So y'all stay tuned. I'm glad y'all got your drawers out y'all booty and y'all was able to tune in. So I'm signing off and I see y'all next week on Cocktails Conversations with your girl, Cornae. CCC Cup. Yeah, I'm super drunk. I drunk Crown Apple. Now I want Tito's. Jesus. No, I'm a Patron drinker.
Yes, that's
okay,
Patron.
Mm-hmm.
Patron, baby, I love it.
I just want to tell you.
Action! I'm tired of people walking around here looking like little baby gorillas. That ain't right. You lay down in the forest, ain't nobody gonna know. It's gonna blend right on in.
This is recording Nate Cutie drinking.